despite being little in the way of expectation before you took the team to the tournament. Well, that's the speculation that Gareth Southgate could be in for a knighthood. Odds on him are being slashed, odds on him being honoured, that is, and a petition has been launched as well. But is getting far in a tournament enough to meet the criteria? Should it be, arise, Sir Southgate, of Garethness? Mark Llewellyn-Slade's an expert in honours. We've had many a slanging match, me and Mark Llewellyn-Slade. He says, I'll help you out. I says, you can't do it. He says, I'll help you out. I say, you can't do it. And he hasn't done it yet. But he's done it for a lot of people. He's from Awards Intelligence. And seriously, it's always lovely having him on the show because he's a real expert. Hello, Mark.
Hello, Malcolm. How are you?
Still waiting. That's how I am.
It's lost in the post, I think.
Lost
it'll
in
get
the...
there. It'll get there.
Lost in the post.
It's coming.
It's coming
home.
Gareth. Me and Gareth. That would be a nice thing, wouldn't it? Me and Gareth up the palace would have lots to talk about. What do you think about this? Should Gareth Southgate... Is it nailed on that he will be a knight, a sir?
I think he will if England win the World Cup. If they crash and bang out tomorrow, I think it's far less likely. I remember England rugby coach Clive Woodward received a knighthood when England won the Rugby World Cup in 2003.
Yeah.
So a precedent's been set there. I think the million-dollar question is, has Gareth gone above and beyond the call of duty? Because people don't get honours for simply doing their job, or at least they shouldn't. Many people, I think, would argue that he has led a bunch of maybe overpaid, underworked young men that should be reasonably expected to have got this far in the competition anyway. Mm-hmm. Although, if they go all the way and win it, I think it will be a different story then.
Isn't getting to the final enough?
Well, who knows? I mean, you know, looking at Clive Woodward, you know, he won it. So there was no doubt that he deserved recognition of the highest order. Should people be knighted for almost making it? I think it's a tough call, that one. I think it's less likely.
Yeah, but he is a nice man and he carries off a waistcoat very well.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. He's the darling of the British people at the moment. He can do no wrong. And I think he's a brilliant leader of our beloved football team. He's clearly inspired them to do well. They're young guys. They need, you know, expert coaching, and they need nurturing on the world stage, and he's doing a great, great job. And I think certainly there'll be a lot of people who will applaud him if he does get the big one, the knighthood.
And Sir Bobby Robson got a knighthood, and he only made it to the semi-finals in Italia 1990.
Oh, well, there you go. Mm. And, of course, and even Pele's got one, probably the greatest footballer ever, of course, so perhaps he deserves one. Which of course shows that anyone based anywhere in the world who meets the criteria can be nominated for a UK honour, like an OBE or a knighthood. You don't have to be a British citizen or even live in the UK. So it's open to any outstanding person across the globe. So if your listeners know of anybody anywhere who they think deserves one, then put pen to paper and get them nominated, I say.
I've got my hand up here.
I know. I know. Well, yours is in. I mean, I reckon dozens of people have put you forward, Mal.
Well, it's Her Majesty then. She's stopping me. She's got something against me, and I don't know why, because I was dilly-dallying around Worcester Racecourse with her daughter the other week. It's not as if I'm not well in with royal circles.
I think it's the post van. It's broken down.
I think it is. So you can't... This is maybe where I am going wrong. You can't get a knighthood just for doing your job, you say.
No, you have to excel in your chosen field. There's essentially two types of people that tend to get honours. Firstly, selfless giving people, such as community and charity workers, philanthropists and that kind of thing. And secondly, those who have excelled in their chosen field, such as eminent radio presenters, surgeons, academics, entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
As I say, you know, Pele's got one for being a brilliant footballer, and lots of actors get them, and we always talk about, you know, the great and the good when it's honours time twice a year. They always get the headlines. But it's really about extraordinary, ordinary people who are doing great work to help others, but they often don't get the headlines they deserve because we always look at the famous stars when it comes round.
Services to waistcoat wearing, that's not going to help, is it, for him?
No, I think he's going to actually have to do something on the pitch.
Yeah, I got you. How about Harry Kane? Harry Kane, he might be close.
Ooh,
now then.
If he keeps scoring, why not? Why not? Although you've got to deliver over a sustained period of time. And Harry Kane's not been in the England setup that long. So whether you'd get an honour for doing well in one tournament's another matter. Even Southgate's only been leading the team for, 2 years? And this is the first major achievement of his two-year tenure. So you could argue he needs to do something else as well, just to show a sustained commitment.
I suspect the old team, if they get to the final, will get some sort of MBE, possibly, won't they?
I'd like to think so, but the tricky thing there, I think, is do you give the same honour to somebody that's played in every game for 90-odd minutes, and also somebody who's come on as a reserve for 5 or 10 minutes in a couple of matches? Do they both deserve the same honour?
I don't know.
Tricky one.
And there are precedents. I mentioned Sir Bobby Robson. Andy Murray got one after winning Wimbledon twice.
He did. But he was around, or is still around, I should say, for a long, long time. Mm. So, again, it wasn't just winning Wimbledon twice over a couple of years. He has won so many Grand Slam tournaments. And didn't he get an Olympic gold medal as well along the way?
Yes. I haven't got an Olympic gold medal or a Wimbledon Grand Slam to me name, see?
Not yet.
Not yet. And as you mentioned, it is obviously on a serious or more serious note, it's the extraordinary, ordinary people that we really should be shouting out from the rooftops. And the way to get an honour for them is to be nominated and to fill in the forms. And that's where sometimes awards intelligence, your lot, come in useful and handy. Yes?
Yeah, absolutely. You've got to be in it to win it. So if your listeners know of anybody they feel is worthy of an honour, then put pen to paper and get them nominated. And if you haven't got time to do it or you want to increase their chances of success, then give us a shout and we'll give you a free, honest assessment at the outset of their chances of success. And we do politely dissuade more people than we persuade.
Well, you've got to be in it to win.
You're brilliant.
Yeah.
Or your friend's brilliant.
Yeah. You've got to be in it to win it. I'm in it up to my neck, but I'm still yet to win it. I'm relying on you, Mark.
It will happen. Have faith, Malcolm.
OK, we'll see what Christmas says. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Malcolm.
Ta-ra.
Bye.
I always end up saying ta-ra in that voice to him, don't I? Mark Llewellyn-Slade. He's an expert.